A cord of length 64 meter is used to connect a 100 kg astronaut to a spaceship whose mass is much larger than that of the astronaut. Assume the value of the tension in the cord. Okay, we have to estimate the value of the tension in the cord. Assume that the spaceship is orbiting near the Earth's surface. Assume that the spaceship and the astronaut fall on a straight line from the Earth's center. Now there are many assumptions in this sum. So the first assumption over here is if this distance is m, and the over here I can say that a satellite of mass m dash is orbiting very close to Earth, and there is a person or there is an astronaut, okay, attached to it. So what are the total forces acting on the, let us first find out for the satellite. There will be tension acting in this direction for the astronaut. It will be acting tension in this direction. The gravitational force will act in this direction, okay, and the resultant centripetal force, which is the resultant, will act in this direction. So I can say that the tension, okay, the tension or the gravitational force, okay, that is Fg minus the tension will be equal to the centripetal force, which is equal to m omega square r, okay, or m dash omega square r. Now the tension can be neglected because over here for a satellite, the tension due to the astronaut will be almost negligible. So the gravitational force over here will be equal to m dash omega square r. Gravitational force is given by the formula G capital M dash divided by capital M dash divided by capital R. Okay. Now understand that instead of small r, I am taking capital R because it is orbiting very close to the Earth. So the distance from the center of the Earth will be approximately equal to the radius of the Earth. So it will be equal to m omega square r. Okay. So m dash omega square r. So m dash and m dash will get cancelled out. It will be equal to, this is r square. Okay. So over here it will be equal to omega dash omega square will be equal to over here. It will be equal to gm divided by r cube. Let this be the first equation and let it be as it is. Okay. Let it be as it is. Okay. Now when this when the same astronaut is moving, he will move with the same angular speed. Okay. So what are the forces acting on this astronaut? Tension in the downward direction, gravitational force in the same direction, in the left hand side direction. It will be equal to the resultant centripetal force, which is equal to m omega square. Its distance will be equal to capital R plus L. Okay. Capital R plus L. Okay. L being the length of the cord. Okay. So over here I can say that tension will be equal to m omega square. Instead of omega square, I will substitute gm divided by r cube, okay, into r plus l minus the gravitational force. The gravitational force over here will be equal to gmm. It will be equal to gmm divided by r plus l the whole square. Okay, r plus l the whole square. Okay, when I substitute the values over here, when I substitute the values of various terms over here, I will get the tension as approximately equal to 3 into 10 to minus 2 newton. Okay, this will be the tension acting in the cord.